There's never enough time, is there? Online shopping, that really helps. You know, it means I don't have to go around the supermarket with two screaming kids shouting, I want chocolate, you know. I mean, I also do online auctions too, both buying and selling. You can always get really good bargains and you can get rid of all your old junk as well. I once had a bit of a bad time with a buyer and that made me a little bit cautious. So I went on to getsafeonline.org to get some advice. Well, it had really good advice on it. The thing is, things aren't as bad as the media makes out. As long as you get some good advice and use your common sense, things are usually fine. It said that I needed to look for reputable sellers. Well, what does that mean? Well, a brand that I trust, and they have a website that has their contact details on it. I mean, I even phoned up one just to make sure. And also there's the golden padlock, where you have to enter your personal information or your credit card details. But the best advice is, it's your money, so if you don't trust it or you get a bad vibe, just walk away. I mean, it's the same thing with online auctions too. After I got ripped off that one time, I always now look at people's feedback scores. And I also like to connect with them personally. I mean, it's good to know how these websites work so that you know what protection you can get. The worst thing is the con men. There's terrible scams out there. They spam you at random, saying you've won the lottery or a dictator's widow will pay you to get her money out of the country. They can be really skillful manipulators though. I mean, once they've got you on the hook, they just reel you in. They want to steal your money or your identity. So however plausible these scams might seem, ask yourself who benefits. If it looks too good to be true, it probably is. I mean, the best thing to do is just ignore them. Don't do anything without getting advice from somebody that you trust, which you can do right here at getsafeonline.org. I work hard for my money and I'm not going to give it away to the first person who asks for it.